Sawadee.
It's Thursday, April 9th. I'm JP Mestanza, and this is Phuket Xtra, brought to you by PSD Windows and Doors. Visa amnesty for foreigners stuck in Thailand is our top story. Let's get started. Weeks after the coronavirus pandemic forced a state of emergency in Thailand, the Immigration Bureau is announcing that all foreigners in Thailand staying on any type of visa that expired on or after March 26 will be granted automatic extensions until April 30th. The amnesty also means foreigners are exempted from doing their 90-day reporting until April 30th. During this time, the 500 baht a day overstay fines have been suspended, but anyone whose visa expired before March 26 and doesn't have it renewed will be fined accordingly. Also, foreigners who have residency in the kingdom and have to return within a year period, well, the Immigration Bureau says that the return has been extended for longer than 1 year. Anyone holding a border pass will be allowed to stay in Thailand for now, but these people must depart Thailand within 7 days of the border crossing points reopening once again. Once the coronavirus pandemic has ended in Thailand and the situation returns to normal deemed by officials, the Immigration Bureau will make a special announcement, and all foreigners are expected to apply for visa extensions and report within 90 days of that time. The whole thing is to avoid scenes like in the past few weeks and restrict public gatherings at immigration offices nationwide amid the COVID-19 pandemic. Stay up to date with the latest at thephuketnews.com. Reports are surfacing on a ban on the sale of alcohol in several parts around the country. Booze bans are being announced for several provinces, the biggest being Bangkok and Chiang Mai, as both will ban alcohol sales from April 10th to the 20th. Booze bans in other provinces have already come into effect, including in Rayong until April 15th, as well as in Buriram, Lampung, Chonburi, Mukdahan, Suphanburi, Surin, and Nakhon Pathom provinces until the end of the month. Phuket has yet to announce a ban on alcohol sales. For the latest, visit thephuketnews.com. The nationwide nightly curfew continues in Thailand from 10 p.m. to 4 a.m. And since the curfew came into effect last Friday, well over 1,000 people on average a night are being caught outside their homes, most of them Thai teens, and they will be prosecuted. All of these people now face legal action, according to authorities, as 1,021 people nationwide were charged for breaking curfew between Tuesday night and Wednesday morning alone. Over 1,000 people on average per night are being prosecuted, facing up to 2 years in prison and or a 100,000 baht fine. But most of the offenders, police say, are teenagers out in groups. Coronavirus numbers are dropping nationwide as officials reported 54 new cases for the country today, the third time in the last 4 days that have seen cases under 100. Thailand now has 2,423 total confirmed COVID-19 cases, and out of that number, 940 have been discharged, 52 alone today. All of the cases are spread over 67 provinces, as well as two more people have also died, as Thailand's death toll stands at 32. Both of today's victims were men, an 82-year-old Thai national and a 74-year-old Frenchman. Bangkok has the highest number of coronavirus cases in the country, with 1,242, followed by Phuket, which jumped Nonthaburi for second place with 161 cases, 21 announced today. Nonthaburi has 142 cases. In Phuket, officials say 104 people are still awaiting COVID-19 test results, but none of the 112 medical personnel who came into contact with a tourist who died from injuries from a crash and later tested positive for the virus, the medical staff tested negative. Out of the new cases in Phuket, most are people who worked or recently visited Patong, but five cases were in Bang Tao and at least one from Rasada in Phuket town. Stay up to date with the latest at thephuketnews.com. The owner of a resort in Rawai is now facing prison time after being charged for accepting a new guest, violating the order for all hotels to close and not allow new check-ins. The 30-year-old Thai owner of the VV Bungalows Resort in Rawai was caught during a police inspection, according to authorities, as he checked in a guest on April 5, and they were meant to check out on April 12. The order for hotels to close and not accept new guests came into effect the day before, on April 4th, 1 day prior to the owner checking in that guest. He's being charged for not only violating the hotel closure order, to which he faces up to a year in prison and or a fine of up to 100,000 baht if found guilty, but also stands to be punished for violating the emergency decree, which carries a maximum penalty of up to 2 years and or a fine of up to 40,000 baht. Meanwhile, police say the tourist who was checked in, she's allowed to stay at the resort. The full April salaries of the administrative officials for Prachuap Kirikan province, just south of Bangkok, they announced they're donating it to help buy protective equipment for volunteer rescue workers in the province. The collective salaries of the members of the Prachuap Kirikan provincial organization, worth about 720,000 baht total, they will be used to buy the personal protective equipment, the PPE, for all the rescue workers on the front lines against the spread of COVID-19 in the province. Many of them volunteers working 24 hours a day, according to officials. Prachuap Kirikan is the province in which one man was found dead on a train and who was later found to have been infected with coronavirus, forcing the quarantine of 14 volunteers. And officials in the province say that since then, they've realized how much proper protection workers need in the province. And that's it for Phuket Xtra today, brought to you by PSD Windows and Doors. For safe, secure, and soundproof windows, visit pvcphuket.com. We want to thank you for joining us again. Don't forget to subscribe to us on YouTube and like us on the Phuket News Facebook page. Until tomorrow, stay classy, Phuket.